Hi students, we are going to discuss about solution part 3. In this solution part 3, we are mainly discussing colligative properties. Okay. In colligative properties, relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, and finally we are discussing about osmotic pressure. In that osmosis, osmotic pressure, and reverse osmosis, and isotonic solution, hypertonic solutions. Like that, we are going to discuss. So mainly we are focusing on colligative properties. First one, relative lowering of vapor pressure. Okay, relative lowering of vapor pressure. So when you add in the non-volatile solute, okay, non-volatile solute we are adding to the solvent. Solvent means what happens? All solvent particles will be present. Then vapor pressure will be, all surface will be have solvent particles. Okay, when you add in the solute particles, then what happens? Some of the surface particles will be replaced with the non-volatile solute. So here only pure solvent is there. So that's why here vapor pressure will be P naught we are taking, and this is the vapor pressure we are taking as a PS. Okay. So here, due to only surface, on surface only solvent particles are present, here vapor pressure will be more will be there, and here vapor pressure will be less will be there. So vapor pressure decreasing upon addition of solute, okay, non-volatile solute. So that we are calling lowering of vapor pressure. Okay, so the lowering of vapor pressure, okay, relative to the initial pressure, we are calling relative lowering of vapor pressure. Suppose I am taking pure solute, okay, I am taking, this is the A is the solvent and B is the solute, non-volatile solute. So when we are taking, generally if your ideal solution PD is equal to P naught A chi A plus P naught B chi B, we will get it, right? But we know that it is a non-volatile solute, P naught B will be equal to zero, and this P total will be nothing but vapor pressure of solution. And this P naught A is nothing but vapor pressure of solvent. So keeping this one here, what we are getting? P total is equal to, instead of total, what we are getting? PS is equal to P naught chi A. This is the expression you are getting. This term becomes zero. And PS is equal to P naught. We can write chi A is equal to 1 minus chi B. Then we can expand this one. P naught minus P naught chi B. From this, what we are getting? PS A minus P naught. We'll get it after this one. P naught minus PS by P naught will be chi. Okay. So the relative lowering of vapor pressure of solute will be directly equal to the mole fraction. That is a basic formula of relative lowering of vapor pressure. This is also called as a Raoult's law for solids in liquid. It is a Raoult's law for solid in liquid. So in this way we are getting a formula, that relative lowering of vapor pressure. So we are taking solvent, pure solvent, that vapor pressure P naught. We are adding the solute, vapor pressure will be decreases. Here P naught will be greater than PS will be there. And we are applying the ideal solution case. Of what happens, so that one, here we already know that this non-volatile solid we are taking, so P naught B will be zero. So applying that, we are getting the expression for the relative lowering of vapor pressure. Okay. So other important formulas in a relative lowering of vapor pressure will go through. First, what we got? The first formula we got, P naught minus PS by P naught is equal to chi B, mole fraction of solute, or number of moles of solute by total number of moles. This is applicable for all solutions. Okay. And if you're taking very dilute solutions, okay, NA is very, very less than NB. Okay, dilute solution we are taking. Then what happens in this case? NA plus NB you can take as approximately NA. Then P naught minus PS by P naught will be equal to NB by NA, that is equal to WP by MB into MA by is the expression we are getting. And we want to know with respect to molality. Molality means what happens? We have to dividing and multiplying with this one, 1000. Then molality into, you will get into 1000 by 1000. You will get MA by 1000. So this is another formula you will get with respect to molality. From this one we can know that a relative lowering of vapor pressure is or lowering of vapor pressure directly proportional to molality. Okay, this will be useful in while expressing the concentration derivation for delta dp and delta tf. Okay, so these are the formulas we are getting. So relative lowering of vapor pressure, and in case suppose we are nd is greater than na, it is not very less than that one, then what we can write? P naught minus ps by p naught. Instead of P naught we are writing PS. Okay, that will be NB by NA. This will be applicable for even concentrated solutions also. Okay, just we have taken this equation NB by NA. So just from modifying this equation we will get it. Okay, so these are important points relative to relative lowering of vapor pressure. And sometimes graph case you have to care vapor pressure versus you are taking the which one? Temperature means you will get the graph like this, and you are taking the log P, log vapor pressure versus 1 by T means you will get the graph like this. Okay. So these two graphs also will be important, sometimes they will ask. So this is a relative lowering of vapor pressure related concept. Next, we are going. Elevation in boiling point, second one, delta T. It is a elevation in boiling point. So what is the boiling point first? When you are, when vapor pressure of liquid equal to the vapor pressure, atmospheric pressure, then it is called as the temperature we are called as a boiling point. So the temperature at which the vapor pressure of liquid equal to the atmospheric pressure we are calling as a boiling point. So if you are taking the liquids, if I am taking here vapor pressure and temperature, solvent will be have more vapor pressure will be there, so it will becomes like this. Solution will becomes like this. This is a solvent phase and this is a solution phase. Solution phase will be have less vapor pressure will be there, and suppose at particular temperature it will be at equal to atmospheric pressure. Okay, so 180 mark 1 bar, then this is TS is the boiling point of solution. This is the T naught will be the boiling point of solvent. So with respect to solvent, solution will have more boiling point. Okay, this difference we are calling as a delta T, elevation in boiling point. Okay, this delta T is a directly proportional to molality. Delta T directly proportional to what? Here from this one you can say directly proportional to delta P. Okay, so vapor pressure change and this one will be there. So delta dB is directly proportional to delta P. We already know that from relative lowering of vapor pressure, delta dB is directly proportional to molality. Since delta dB is directly proportional to molality. Okay, from that we can get delta dB is equal to KB into M. This is the first formula we will require for what? It is the molality. And another formula you can write KB into here WB by MB into 1000 by molecular weight of solvent A. So this is another formula you can write for the delta TB. And here KB is called as the molar elevation constant. And what is the expression will be there for KB? KB is equal to RTB square 1000 by latent heat of vaporization will be there, or RTB square into molecular weight of solvent by 1000 into delta H vaporization will be there. Okay, latent heat of vaporization is equal to delta H by molecular weight. So this KV formula we have like this. So this is the elevation case, and here important thing, delta TB is what? ts minus t0, ts minus t0. So the change in the one, because ts will be have more boiling point, t0 less will be more, minus less we are doing, that is the elevation in boiling point will be given. So when you add in non-volatile solute, vapor pressure of solution will be decreases, that's why boiling point will be increases, that we are calling elevation in boiling point expression, important expression for the delta dv given here. Okay, similarly we can have similar formulas related to which one, depression in freezing point. Okay, that is also important. What is the depression in freezing point? Delta T. Okay, so here what is the first freezing point? Freezing point means the temperature at which the vapor pressure of liquid equal to the vapor pressure of solid, that we are calling as a freezing point. Generally, if you, how you will graphically explain, this is the vapor pressure of solid we are taking. Okay, at particular point this solvent will be have vapor pressure like this, and solution will be have vapor pressure like this. So this particular point, vapor pressure of liquid and solid will be equal. This particular pressure, vapor pressure of solid and solution will be equal. So this is related to the solvent. Okay, T naught. This is the Ts. This is the vapor pressure versus temperature. So compared to solvent, temperature is decreasing, that's why it is called as a depression in freezing point. Here depression in freezing point have also same formulas are related, like that delta Tf is equal to Kf into m. M is a molality, Kf is a molar ebullioscopic constant in case of here, cryoscopic constant in case of depression in freezing point. Kf into this Wb by Mb into 1000 by weight of solvent. Same formula, similar formula. And also you will have the expression for Kf or Tf square freezing point by 1000 into latent heat of fusion or Tf square molecular weight of solvent by 1000 delta H vaporization. Okay, these are the formulas you are getting. And here what is the delta Tf? Tf is equal to P naught minus Ts will become, because T naught will be more than Ts. So these are the relations you are getting. Okay, so this delta Tf and delta Tb, you want to find the relation, what we will get it? Delta Tb by delta Tf is equal to Kb into M by Kf into M. This same concentration we are using, then it will be get cancelled. So delta Tb by delta Tf is equal to Kb by K. Okay. If different solutions are there, M1 by M2 also will be here. Okay. This is the relation between delta Tf and delta Tb. Okay. So first, freezing point. Freezing point will be the temperature at which the vapor pressure of solid and liquid will be equal, that we are calling freezing point. And related formulas, relation between delta T and delta T. Next one, we have osmotic pressure, fourth one. This osmotic pressure represented by, okay, before going osmotic pressure, first we will get to know what is osmosis. So we are taking two containers and separated by semi permeable membrane. Okay, either this side you have concentrated solution you have, or solution you have. Okay, concentrated solution or solution we have, and this side you have dilute solution or solvent only. Okay, and in this case what happens, Here water molecules will be more and here water molecule will be less will be there. These water molecules, solvent particles moving through semi-permeable membrane from dilute solution to concentrate solution or solvent to solution, we are calling as a osmosis. Okay. And what is the osmotic pressure? The pressure which will be stop the osmosis, the pressure which will be stop the osmosis, that will be called as a osmotic pressure. Okay. So osmotic pressure is the pressure will be stopping the osmosis. Okay. And we are applying pressure greater than osmotic pressure. What happens? What happens? The solvent particles move opposite. Okay. Solvent particles move from concentrated solution to dilute solution or solution to solvent. That we are calling as a reverse osmosis. Reverse osmosis. So these are the key points or some basic definition. Osmosis and osmotic pressure, and we have reverse osmosis. RO system. We are using reverse osmosis. And basically osmosis we are using to find the molecular weights of high molecular weight having compounds like proteins, polymers, case we are using. And important formulas related to osmotic pressure, what we have. So first one is a pi is equal to CRT. It is like PV is equal to NRT type. We can write instead of C, we can write what? We can write pi is equal to N by V RT. So from this, we can also write pi V is equal to NRT. Like PV is equal to NRT, pi V is equal to NRT. Okay. And also we want most of the time molecular weight, that is WV by MB. MB is the molecular weight. So we can write RT by. This formula we are using for doing the problems. We want to find molecular weight of polymers and molecules. Yes, we are using these formulas. Okay. Next one. These are the formulas we have. Okay. So some cases you have pi 1 equal to pi 2. Two solutions we have. They have equal osmotic pressure. They are called as isotonic solutions. What they are called? Isotonic solutions. For isotonic solutions, C1 equal to C2 at given temperature, because pi is equal to CRT. R and T is constant means C1 equal to C2. And if they are same substances are there, okay. So same value at volume and temperature is constant, N1 equal to N2. And W1 equal to W2 at a given substance will be same. And volume and temperature constant means W1 equal to W2. But this is for isotonic solutions we will get it. And if they are not isotonic, if it is greater than one is less, okay, which is less, that is the hypotonic solution. Which is less, that is called as hypotonic solution. Which is more, that is called as a hypertonic solution. Okay, so which will be have less osmotic pressure or less concentrated solution, that is a hypotonic solution. More concentrated or more osmotic pressure having solutions are called hypertonic solutions. Okay. And suppose in turn, sometimes questions will be asked like this. We are taking the animal cell. Okay, we are taking animal cell. And we are kept in the first case, we kept in hypotonic solution. Same animal cell we are taking and we are kept in hypertonic solutions. Hypotonic and hypertonic solution we are kept. This is hypotonic means inside what you have? Hypertonic. Okay. So it is C, concentration is will be more will be there. And your concentration will be less will be there. due to osmosis what happens? Less concentrated to more concentrated water molecule will be moved. So less concentrated hypotonic to more concentrated will be moved. So water molecules will be shifted like this. When it will be there, then what happens? Swelling will be takes place. And same way here, this hypotonic means inside the cell what will be have? Hypotonic. So concentration will be less will be there. And here concentration will be more will be present. Due to osmosis what happens? The water molecule will become from inside to out. Okay. That's why what happens? A shrink will be takes place. The cell will be shrink. Same way you have blood cell you are taking. Okay. Its concentration 0.9 W by B percentage will be present. W by B percentage will be present. You are taking any solution and in terms of molarity 0.154 around mole per liter will be there. If you are taking any solution, salt solution, we are taking blood cells above this one, it will be act as a hypertonic solution. Below that one, it will act as a hypotonic solution. And if both are equal, it is isotonic solutions it will be formed. Okay. So this is the related to isotonic hypertonic cells related. Okay. So these are the colligative properties that we have discussed. Okay, relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, osmotic pressure. Okay. And these all colligative properties are depend on number of particles, does not depend on nature of the particles. That's why they are called as the colligative property. The colligative properties mainly used to finding the molecular weight of unknown substances. If your compounds are having low molecular weight, they will use the first three methods. And the high molecular weight like protein molecules or polymers, we are using the osmotic pressure we are using. Okay. So this is about pottery. Next case, we will discuss about the abnormal molar masses and applying that Wanta factor to the colligative properties. Okay. Thank you.